Hey everyone, welcome back to another Mining Chamber video. In today's video, we are going to review the RTX 3070 for mining. So we're going to talk about the pricing, where to buy it from, and how much you should be paying for it, as well as how much money it makes you and what overclock settings you should be using for it. So now let's go ahead and get into this right after the intro. The RTX 3070 is a great GPU for mining. It comes very close to the RTX 3060 Ti, which we previously reviewed on our channel. So they have a very similar hash rate, just the RTX 3070 does do better in other algorithms as well. So in this video, we are going to be using the Gaming X Trio model. I didn't buy this myself, but my roommate bought it and he's getting into mining as well. So I ended up using his GPU for this review. Now the first thing I want to say about this card is it looks phenomenal, it's a beautiful card, and MSI in general never fails in making their stuff pretty. So it does run off of 2 8 pins, and it only takes around 130 watts power when it's mining, so it's not bad at all, it's a very efficient card. It would have been great if it had only a single 8 pin, but unfortunately it's running with 2, so when it comes to building a full mining rig with this card, it does take some cables and some splitters. Now with the Gaming X Trio model, the backplate is not metal, it's plastic, which is not good, but since this card barely consumes any power, it won't be a problem. But if you're looking for 3080s or 3090s, then it can be an issue. So now before we put our overclocks on this card and start testing it, let's first talk about the costs and how much you should be paying for it and which brands are good to use. So where can you buy the RTX 3070? On Amazon, you can barely find any, and if you do, there won't be shipping anytime soon, plus they will be on a really expensive price. So Amazon is not one of the best options for it now, but I will leave links for Amazon below, so maybe when they do release new ones on Amazon, you can catch that one right away. So whatever you're seeing now, it probably won't be reflecting all the time. So if you're watching this video 1 year from now, we won't know where the market will be heading, so you might find GPUs or you might not find GPUs. And on Newegg it will be the same thing, so you will hardly be able to find anything here. Now I do use the stock radar bot still, where it tells you when it fills out in stock again, but it does go away super fast. So if you want to join the stock radar Discord, the link will be in the descriptions below, so you can feel free to try your luck in catching one of these sales. So now the one place I am able to find these GPUs is at aaawave.com. So you guys can see here they have the 3070s as well as the 3080s and two different brands of the 3080s as well as a couple of other cards. So this is the place that you can try to buy them from, although yes, the prices are very expensive, but it is hard to find these cards anywhere. Now if you do decide to buy from aaawave.com, you can go ahead and use our coupon code right here, so you will be able to get up to $20 off of your order by using this coupon. You will find these coupons on miningchamber.com/stores, so feel free to visit the site whenever you want to find any coupons for one of the stores that we have here. So that's basically it for the availability. It's very hard to find these cards, but hopefully it will change when Nvidia decides to release some more cards. Now as for the brands, honestly all of them are good. The 3070s don't use too much power, so you don't need to worry about models that have bad cooling since it doesn't use that much power. Now you can feel free to grab any model you like or any model that you find for cheap. So now for the profitability, you guys will be able to find RTX 3070 mining settings and profitability on miningchamber.com. This link will be in the descriptions below as well. Here you're going to be able to find a lot of information that will be more up to date, so feel free to visit this article as well as watching this video. And if you scroll down here, you will find the profitability. So with the RTX 3070, we are able to get around 60 mega hash, and our daily estimated earnings will be around $7.66. Now just remember, these numbers always change, so now it's making really good money, but maybe in the future it will make less or more. So if we're making $7.66 a day, you will be able to make around $230 a month, which is really good. So depending on what price you bought this GPU for, so if it's around $1,000 or more, your break even will be around 5 months to 6 months. That is depending on the numbers if they change from now or not. Now when we go to whattomine.com, you will find the RTX 3070 is most profitable with Ethereum as of the date of this video. And once Ethereum also goes away to proof of stake, you still have Ravencoin and CoinFlux, and it's doing really good on those two. So it's almost the same profitability as Ethereum when you're mining CoinFlux, and Ravencoin is also catching up there pretty well. That's why Nvidia cards are pretty safe, because they are pretty diverse in what they can mine. and that gives you a backup plan once Ethereum goes away. So now that wraps it up for the profitability. Let's go ahead and put this GPU in our test bench and give you guys a couple of notes on plugging this GPU with power. So since this GPU takes 2 8-pins and you're trying to build a rig out of it, I would definitely recommend using splitters. And since it only takes around 130 watts, you guys can plug in 1 strand from your PSU to your GPU. So you can plug into it a splitter, and then you can power the GPU and the riser by 1 cable. So you don't have to use too many cables on 1 GPU. Now, since I have here on the test bench, I have 2 cables and I'm only powering 1 GPU, I won't be using any splitters, but you guys can do the method that I just told you about. Now, we're going to be testing this GPU first on Windows, and then we're going to take it to HiveOS, which will be the equivalent of a Linux-based mining operating system. So like that, you guys will know what overclock settings you should be using in Windows or HiveOS. The settings are the same, it's just the numbers are different because of the way that they are implemented. So before we start overclocking the card, let's first mine with the stock settings so you guys can see what it can do in stock settings. So I'm going to go ahead and run my Phoenix miner. So this is my current script. I don't have anything extra here, just my address and the pool, which is flex pool, and then a couple of commands here that are not required for your Nvidia card, so you don't need to worry about it. So now let's go ahead and run Phoenix miner as an administrator and see how much hash rate and power we're using. So for hash rate, we're getting around 52 mega hash, and for power, we're drawing around 250 watts, which is crazy amount. It's a lot of power. That is why you should always overclock your cards for mining so you don't use that much power. Now, as for the temperatures, you guys can see here, it's climbing steadily. It's almost at 50 degrees Celsius, and the fan speed are not kicking in at all because it's set at auto. So if I go ahead and remove auto and then I put the fan speed at a certain number, for example, 71%, and then I can run this, you'll see the temperatures will start dropping a lot more. So always try to avoid auto because it basically never moves, and it's only going to kick in when the core temp is getting pretty high. And usually when you're mining Ethereum, your memory temperatures are getting hot, not your core temperatures. So now that we tested the stock settings, let's go ahead and get started with overclocking the card. So for overclocking, you guys will be able to find that on the website as well. So if you scroll down, you will find the overclock section, and as of now we just have it for Ethereum, which is on the Ethash algorithm. So what you can do is you can use these overclocks and then you can fine tune them based on your GPU. So these are just a base for you to go off of, and then if you know how to fine tune your GPUs, you can go ahead and fine tune them. But if you don't know, you can use this video right here for overclocking, and then it will teach you the basics of overclocking and what values you can mess around with to be able to get the maximum performance. Now, this doesn't mean these overclocks are bad, it's just that if you want to push it to the limits, then you can feel free to do so. So we're going to be using MSI Afterburner to overclock in Windows 10. And once we go ahead and put in all the settings that we need, we will be able to see here that we are getting around 60 mega hash, which is pretty good. And then we're drawing off of the wall around 160 to 170 watts, and 30 of those watts are for the system. So then the rest would be just for the GPU, which would leave us around 130 watts for the GPU. So it's a really efficient card and not a bad card for mining at all. And since at the time of this video, the most profitable coin to mine is Ethereum, that's the only one I'll give you guys an example for. But then eventually when a new coin comes out that's more profitable than Ethereum, I will be making a video on that as well. So now let's go ahead and move on to testing it on HiveOS. So to be able to run your RTX 3070 or any RTX 3000 series cards in general, you need to upgrade your drivers to the 455 version. So just go ahead and run a HiveOS shell, and then from the HiveOS shell, when you sign into it, you can use the Nvidia driver updater command and then do the version 455. So after that update finishes, you'll be able to see here your Nvidia drivers are version 455. Now, if you already have these drivers, you don't need to worry about it. But if you have lower than 455, then please go ahead and update your drivers. So now to apply the overclocks that we used in Windows here, all we need to do is go ahead and hit on the overclock settings, and then we can go ahead and add our overclocks. So for the core clock, we'll do negative 500, and then for the memory clock, we will do 2200, because it doesn't take it as an offset here. So you guys can see here from the tooltip, it says if in Windows it's plus 800, then here it should be 1600. So therefore in Windows we had plus 1100, and now here we will be putting 2200. Now as for the fan speed, I'll just go ahead and put this as 60%, and for the power limit, I'll do 130 watts. You can leave the rest of it blank, and now you can go ahead and do apply. So now that our overclocks are in place, we can go ahead and run the flight sheet. So I'm just going to run this one, which is on Phoenix miner and flex pool, and then here we can see that we're getting around 60 mega hash and we're pulling around 130 watts. So it's pretty good where it stands right now, and that is the overclock settings for HiveOS. Now we went ahead and tested the overclocks on Windows as well as on HiveOS, which applies for any Linux-based mining operating system. We can go ahead and talk about the conclusion. So what are my opinions on this card as of performance-wise, and how about the price at the time of this video coming out? So for performance, this GPU is great. It does give you a good amount of hash rate for a low amount of power, which is great for efficiency, and it does do pretty well on other algorithms as well. So now from a pricing standpoint, at the date of this video being recorded, which is February 21st, 2021. We can see it at very expensive prices, but we don't know when the prices will go back to normal. So if you are eager to get into mining and you don't mind the cost, then you can go for it. But I would recommend being patient with it and trying to scour out for good deals. And Nvidia said that they will be restricting the firmware so that they can get the maximum hash rate of the GPU, although we don't really know where this is heading, but eventually I will be making a full video on that topic. So in a nutshell, this GPU is a great card. If you can find it for a decent price, I would say around $800 USD would be acceptable, even though that's almost double the MSRP. Now that will be it for the video, guys. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. And if you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe. Thank you guys again, and I hope you have a wonderful day.